Welcome to this episode of Understanding Gradle, where we continue to look at Java modularity. In the previous videos, we have looked at the ClassPath concept of Java, and in the last video, we've learned how we can improve the compiler ClassPath by fixing dependency scopes and detecting unused dependencies using the dependency analysis plugin. Another issue that you can have on your ClassPath is the duplication of classes. That is, the same class with the same name and the same package is on the ClassPath multiple times. This can lead to problems when the order of ClassPath entries changes, for example, between your compiler ClassPaths and your application's runtime ClassPath. To understand how Java behaves in these cases, let's have a look at an example. I've now changed the code in our example application to print us the location of the jar where a certain class is loaded from. Again, I'm using MimeType from the JavaX activation library as an example here. Let's run Java directly and check how Gradle behaves afterwards. We start our application with the Java command, giving it a class path that consists of the jar containing our own application and a JavaX activation jar that I've downloaded before. If we run this, we see that the class is taken from the jar as expected. Now I've downloaded another version of JavaX activation. If we compare the two jar files, we can see that a lot of classes are contained in both of them. Also, the MimeType class. Although, there are a few changes in the code between these two classes. So typically, you want to control which of these two implementations is used in your application. So now what happens if we put both these versions on our class path? If we add the additional jar at the end of our class path and run the application, we see that the same jar was picked as before. This is because Java always picks the first occurrence of a class on the class path, silently ignoring other occurrences. So if we exchange the order of the two activation jars on the class path, now Java will pick the other jar because it's the first it encounters that contains the class it's looking for. Now, this can be a problem if you have multiple class paths in your multi-module application, as we have explored in the previous videos. You might end up having a certain order on your compiler class paths, but a different order in the application runtime class path. So the code you run against is not the one you compile against. And although it's not the case in this example, even the public API of the class you're using might have changed, and you might get some ugly runtime errors. So ideally, you want to avoid having duplicates on any of your class paths at all. Let's have a look how Gradle can help you with this. Now, instead of using the Java tool directly, we want to run our application through Gradle. For this, I have declared a dependency to JavaX activation in our build Gradle file. If we now run the application through Gradle, we see that the jar from the Gradle caches is used. So Gradle calls the Java command with a class path that contains this jar from its caches. Now what happens if we add a dependency to the other version of JavaX activation to our build file as well? Typically, you won't do this, adding a dependency to different versions of the same library in one of your modules, but you could easily get several versions of a library through transitive dependencies. I talk about this and show an example of it in my video on dependency version conflicts. Now here, for demonstration purposes, we declare both dependencies directly in our app module. If we run the application again with Gradle, we see that the higher version of the jars is used. And even if we exchange the order of the dependency declarations in the build file, still the higher version is used. This is because Gradle only puts one of the jars on the class path, even though the dependency has been declared multiple times with different versions. To see what's going on, we can use Gradle's dependencies help task. So if we call the dependencies task on the app project for the runtime class path, we see that Gradle resolved both of the dependency declarations to the same version, which is the higher one. This is because Gradle detects a dependency version conflict between these two jars because they have the same group and name in their coordinates and then picks by default the higher version. I go into more detail on this in my video on dependency version conflicts. So in this case, using Gradle instead of plain Java again helped us to avoid having this unnecessary conflict on our class paths. Gradle has the assumption that if you have dependencies with the same coordinates, that this is the same component, and thus has overlapping packages and classes. And from that, draws the conclusion that only one of the jars should be on the class path because otherwise you get the conflicts between the classes. And thus it does the conflict resolution picking only one of these jars. But this is based on the assumption that duplicated classes only occur in different versions of the same component, like in this case javax.activation:activation. But there is nothing that prevents library authors to publish the same classes in different components, so components with different groups and names. For example, in the case of JavaX Activation, there has been a rename to Jakarta Activation. There is now a new component, jakarta.activation:jakarta-activation-api. But if you pick a 1.x, so for example 1.2 version of this component, it has the same classes in it as the 1.x version of JavaX Activation, which we can see if we compare the jars. If we now add this dependency to Jakarta Activation as an additional dependency to our app module and run the application, we can see that even though Jakarta has a higher version, still the 1.1.1 JavaX Activation version was picked for the MimeTime class. Even worse, if we change the order of dependencies in our build script and put the Jakarta Activation dependency first, the Jakarta Activation jar is selected. This is because here Gradle actually didn't detect the conflict, and we have two jars on the class path again, the Jakarta Activation API jar and the Activation jar from JavaX. We can also see that if we run the dependencies task and look at the dependency resolution result, where both Jakarta and JavaX were selected, even though they contain the same classes. And this is because Gradle didn't know that these two components are in conflict because they have different groups and names. Now, what do we do in these cases? The first thing would be to detect that we have conflicts on a class path, because only if we know that, we can do something about it. And as we have seen multiple times now, the Java tool just silently ignores the duplications and does not inform us about them. Luckily, Gradle can help us here again and tell us that there are conflicts on the class path. There's a nice community plugin, the Class Path Collision Detector, that you can use for it. Let's use this plugin by adding a dependency in our convention plugins and by applying it in our application convention plugin. Because the most important thing to check for conflicts is the runtime class path of our application, which is what the plugin checks by default. The only thing the plugin does is add a detect collisions task, which looks into the jar files on the class path and checks for duplicated entries. If we call this task now for our app module, it will inform us about all the duplicated classes in the JavaX Activation and the Jakarta Activation API jar. So this is a simple tool you can easily add to your project to check if there are still conflicts on your runtime class path undetected by Gradle. Now that we have found the conflict, what do we do about it? For Gradle, conflicts like this, having the same classes in multiple jars from different components, are capability conflicts. I did a separate video only about this topic, which you can check out to understand all the details of this. Essentially, a capability conflict occurs if two different components implement the same interfaces or provide the same classes, so they provide or implement the same capability. This means we or Gradle should only pick one of them, because they can't technically be used both together on one class path. To let Gradle detect and resolve such a conflict, the metadata of the component need to contain this capability information, which in most cases, unfortunately, is not yet the case, as I also explained in the video on capability conflicts. But Gradle allows you to add this missing metadata using so-called component metadata rules. I have started a plugin that collects all the rules for the metadata that is missing for commonly used components in the Java ecosystem. It's called the orgradlex Java Ecosystem Capabilities plugin. If we add this plugin as well to our build, first adding the dependency to the buildgradle file of the convention plugins, and then applying it to all of our projects by adding it to our base convention plugin, then this metadata that is not available in the repositories of the components is now known to Gradle. The JavaX Activation versus Jakarta Activation case, which is our example here, is already covered by this plugin. So now with the plugin applied, if we run the detect collisions task again, we see that there are no conflicts on our runtime class path anymore. And we see that now the Jakarta Activation API with the higher version, the 1.2 version, is picked, even if it's not the first on our dependency declarations. If we run the dependencies task for the runtime class path, we see that now the conflict has been detected and all three dependency declarations have been resolved to the Jakarta 1.2 version of activation. If you use the Java Ecosystem Capabilities plugin in your project, but still get collisions detected by the Detect Collisions task, you can add your own component metadata rule in addition. I briefly talked about this in the video on capabilities conflicts. And if the undetected conflict is concerning public Java libraries, it would be great if you could report or even contribute your additional component metadata rule to the plugin. I very much appreciate such feedback and contributions, because then we as a community working in the Java ecosystem can help each other to enable Gradle to detect more conflicts automatically. In this video, we talked about conflict on your class paths by having duplicated classes. We have seen that Java itself just silently ignores such conflicts, which can cause unexpected behavior. We saw how Gradle helps us to avoid these conflicts in the first place, and how you can check if you have such undetected conflicts in your own project. And we saw that you can make such conflicts known to Gradle by using the Java Ecosystem Capabilities plugin or adding your own component metadata rules, so that you won't have such conflicts anymore on all your class paths constructed by Gradle. In the next video, we'll have a look at security vulnerabilities in external libraries. Please subscribe to this channel so you won't miss this next video. See you then.